Welcome on board again today, my wonderful viewers. From the little we just seen, let's continue from here. Watch this video first before we talk about what we'll be explaining much better.
Don Genius, spinning the wheels of steel.
So from this brief intro, you can see that the concept that is being dealt with here is the concept of wordplay. Yes. Wordplay is a very simple concept, mostly applicable by most people on the normal controller, but most people don't know how to go about using the virtual DJ software, especially the keyboard, to do it. So today you are actually watching the right video. I'm going to smash it and explain everything in detail as it is expected of you. If you look at the people who do most of the wordplay in most cases, you notice that one finger is always playing around with the crossfader, which brings on and off, and then the other one is trying to ensure that you start the song just like a hot cue. So that is why how I borrowed these two concepts. So the two concepts we are going to be dealing with is playing around with the crossfader, which turn on and off the sound. I will show you the key, and then the other part that deals with picking up the song at a starting point continuously, where you every time you press it, it starts from the beginning again. So we are going to be seeing it. So first we have our sample, which is a very common sample here. Look at it, scratch 10. Look at it, it's been loaded on the deck already. So it's not something you should worry yourself about. I'll make it available in the link of the description. There's a common link I've been providing all this while for people to download drum pad, even the virtual DJ software, the Bandicam software I'm using. The list is endless. I've even asked people to drop their DJ drop name so that I'll make samples for them. It's all there. So let's go into the business of the day. First, you have your beating, which is on our deck one. Look at it here. Yeah, this is a common beating. Yes, get a beating that you really like, or the beating that will flow along with it. Don't worry, I'm actually using the Afro beat for now. I'm going to pick a hip hop sound. I also play around with it, maybe possibly in my subsequent video, mommy, and a host mommy, of others. Mommy. So we have seen our beating. Mommy. So we have seen our beating. Let's now see the sample that is being used. So we'll divide the sound into two. I'm going to play it in full first. Look at it.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
So this is yeah, it's a very common sample. So just watch. I won't be playing the beat on it. I'm going to be playing around with it alone. Look at it. So this is how you play with it on the beating as it is going. Don't worry, I know there are scratches in that particular video I showed you. Don't worry, we are going to see how we are going to incorporate it and even play around with maybe the tempo, the BPM, as a host of others as we progress. But in this part, we are going to be dealing with the elementary, which is very simple and straightforward. So one thing I like about the virtual DJ software is a concept that really makes it very difficult if you understand little knowledge of programming and how the code is being read. Just as I've said, you know, on several of my videos, the code is read from the left of your hand to the right, then from the top of the screen down to the lowest part. So the reason why, no matter how they try to automate things, I still have it at the back of my mind that they can never beat the human imagination. That is why I still use the concept of the power of the imagination in my logo. So since it is like that, the human aspect can read anything from this keyboard at any point in time. If you ask the computer to read it, it will first read it from this side and goes this way, then come to the left line until from the top of this keyboard down. So that is what makes it different from the human being. So no matter how they try to automate, it cannot get to that stage. So back to the business of the day. The reason why I'm explaining this is because we are going to be dealing with the code, and I'm going to be explaining some things about how we write the code that way. Because if you go against it, the device will not work. So that is why a lot of resources are being invested in learning, in designing this software, and even go with the aspect of a software testing and a host of others, so that they can get how they can modify it to improve. So let's see the script. Let's start with the script and see what it's all about. So if you watch my keyboard, there are two keys we are going to be dealing with majorly here, and I'm going to explain why. We have letter H, we also have letter J. Don't worry, this J and K, they play similar role. They are both Q play, they are both hot Qs. But in most cases, some people prefer to use the Q underscore play, which is the normal key I've used here, which is letter Q. Don't worry, let's watch it first. This is it, letter C, Q underscore play. It will also give you that starting of the song at a particular point in time and end it when you release your hand. But it's not going to be as effective as using this letter J. Don't worry, the script here, I've adjusted it. But don't worry, I will also make it available in that link as we progress. And all this code will be available in the description of this video too. So we have our hot cue, which is a normal hot cue. As I've told you, you are always starting the song at a particular point in time. Then this is it, and this is a combination. That means we are telling to combine this instruction. This is our up condition, which is asking for the condition of the keyboard, of a particular key on the keyboard. That is our letter G. Then the first highlighted part, which is the command that will be executed, which is this deck default level 100%. That means when we press this key at the initial stage, our volume will remain high, but the moment we release it, the volume will go down. That is why we call it ternary operator. It's asking for a condition. This is the second part of the condition here. Ignore this first part that talks about 50% first. It's for the filter, which ensures that our filter is at 50%. Then we have our level 100%. This means whenever we press this particular letter J, as it is starting the song at a particular point in time, it's going to be taking our level volume to 100% again. That is, so the same thing is applicable here too. This K2 is the same thing, but in this case we are dealing with, so this is it. So this is a complete code. Don't worry, it's going to be highlighted on the screen wider. So as I've explained everything in detail, then this same K is the same thing. The only difference is the Q point. This is starting at Q point 2. So the first part of the Q point is R. Let's see it. I'm going to use it now. Look at it. The first point, which is letter J, look at it, the first Q point. This is the second part, which is. So can you see it? Why am I picking hot Q against the Q underscore play? Look at it, which is this, our letter C. Look at it. It's the same thing. The only difference there is we have our Q underscore play. Then it's actually on the, ignore this other part, is not, this is the key point, the starting of the song. The reason is very simple. If you use Q underscore play, the chances of repeating the starting of the effect is very slim. But if you use hot Q, the hot Q will give you that flexibility of starting it rapidly. Just watch. This is my hand, this is J. We are going to be starting with the initial start of the song. This is hot Q, this is the same hot Q, but in this case this is hot Q 1. Then there's a volume, as I've explained. Whenever I press this particular key, it makes the volume 100%, and whenever I release it, the volume goes back to 0. The song is actually playing. It will play continuously, but it's going to be starting it again from the beginning. While in the case of this Q underscore play, it will only start it, but it will not allow it to play, which reduces our flexibility of playing around with it like see. This one give us but the moment we want to go more complex, the effectiveness stop there. That is why we are not using it. So but in the case of this one, just watch. Can you see? That is the beauty of the whole thing. Then the same thing which is here, there is, then if you haven't watched my video on how to play this drum pad, I think you really need to watch how I talked about placing your fingers. It's the same concept that we are using here to play around with these two keys. So that video will really help you too, so that you know how to place your finger while this one is going down, this one is coming up. So that is it, just the way you play on the normal drum. See, can you see? So can you see? So if you are conversant with playing this drum part, how you ensure that one sound follows the other one immediately is the same thing you use here. I'm sure this video will really be of help if you are not too conversant with the drum sample or playing around with drum on the keyboard. So with this brief introduction, I'm sure you've really get to appreciate how we play it on the normal controller as well as on the drum pad. Sorry, on the keyboard. So the same concept that we are using on the drum pad, which in this case you don't have the crossholder to play around, is the keys that you play with. So there will be little modification on how you play it on the keyboard, on the controller, than here. So you can see how you can flow either on the controller or on the keyboard. In as much as I know a lot of people are more comfortable with the controller, but sometimes you prefer to use this one, will be give you more added advantage. And as we continue to tweak the code, I'm going to be making it available as we progress. So thank you very much for being there, my wonderful audience. I'm going to be making this on the aspect of the hip hop too, and a host of other aspect. So thank you. Let's enjoy the fire. It's your
genius DJ.
Just